Hello friends, welcome. In today's session, we are going to discuss on how to configure Selenium scripts in Jenkins and configure with the Allure reports. Allure is a plugin available for Selenium test reports. So we can configure that and we can see how dashboard and how Allure can produce the test summary reports. So we have seen TestNG and extent reports, right? So similarly, Allure report is also one of the type wherein it will create a dashboard. It will segregate test cases based on the various format. Let's see. So for today's session, I have created this into two parts. In part first, we will see a basic Selenium script. We are trying to execute that, and TestNG script will configure that. Then to run Allure reports, we need to configure few things within the Selenium script, and also in Jenkins we need to configure few add-ons and things like that. Let's get started. I'll go one by one. The agenda is, first, we will configure the Selenium scripts along with Allure installation. Okay, so for the demo purpose, I have already have one small test Selenium test scripts. This is downloadable from the Guru99 site. So what I did, I just downloaded that script and I configured. And I converted this project to a Maven project. That once you downloaded the project, right click and go to configure, and since it's already converted, so that option is not here. So here you will get one option to convert the project to Maven. So once it's converted, we get this menu, and also it's a TestNG project, so we get this, right? If it is not a TestNG project, through this option we can convert to TestNG also. Similarly, once it's converted, we can convert that to Maven project as well. So other basic things are like, you know, how to add Selenium jars, how to set up Eclipse IDE, and how to configure Maven home path, and also Java home path. I'm not going to touch and show those things. Just I'll show and I'll explain what is this script basically, and what is that we need add-ons to run from the Jenkins. So our focus is on the Jenkins and the Allure side rather than the Selenium script, creating the Selenium script and executing the Selenium script. So let's understand the form XML for this project, for this setup, what and all we need. So if you look at this form XML, right? So here the basic thing that we need are dependencies are like JInit and Selenium, TestNG, POI to basically read the, you know, Excel data. We have data created here. Then this is the main dependency that we need for Allure. So this dependency available in the Maven site, just copy the dependency and place it here. 2.12 and 2.13 also there, so I just copied 2.12. and next thing is that you need Maven compiler and show file, and this is the suite I have configured here. So this is the pretty much for the form, Maven form site. So once this is done, so just to make sure that your configuration of the Selenium script along with the test engine Maven setup is runnable, so just try that. And I have already executed the script. If you see, this is my result. So there are 7 test cases executed, so all of them got passed. So it's just like, you need to, once configuration done, you just go right click and run as TestNG suite. So yeah, this is pretty much like all your project will have similar kind of setup. So the intention for me in today's session is to explain more in the Jenkins side and the Allure setup side. So I hope there will not be any further explanation on this setup is required. If anything is there, just comment, send me comment. I'll be happy to address your questions. It's just download any sample project, set up in the Eclipse, add required dependencies, run in the TestNG format. Make sure that you are able to produce some TestNG reports. Okay, this is the part one. So let's go to the part second. Before that, this setup in the dependency, we have added Allure dependency, right? So 2.2.2.1.20. This is one thing. Second thing is that you also need to add this in the environment variable under this path. So to do that, very simple approach we have. Just type run command, right? Then type PowerShell, click on OK. So what it does, it will open PowerShell window, and from here there are some commands that we need to execute. I'll show you what are those. So once PowerShell is ran, right, the window appears, then just execute this command, set execution policy remote signed scope. If you are first time using it, it will run, no issue. Otherwise, it says that I have already configured, so I'm getting message saying that you have it already, so do you want to confirm it again, right? So I said yes. Then once this is done, this is the Allure downloading path. Just copy as it is. Okay, copy. Okay, then right click. It will run. If it is a new install, it will install it. If it is already installed, it just says that scoop already installed. So what I can do, I can run this scoop update. So if I run this scoop update, I have 2.1.2, right? So if any latest version other than that, it will just configure in my system. So by doing this, you don't have to go manually and set the home path in the environment variables section, right? So other ways, download Allure zip, right? Same like how you configure Maven. Similarly, you have to download it and place it in some folder and give the path of that folder in the environment variables. So this is very very neat installation, because we often see that whenever we set the home path in the environment variables, it will not fetch correctly. There will be always some mistakes and there will be always some readable issue. So the best way is just open PowerShell. These are all the two commands that you need to give. That's it. Your Allure configuration is done. Okay, so once this is done, just type scope install Allure. It will install the Allure, right? If it is not, if it's already installed, just it will give me the scope update. Okay, I will explain once again. First thing is that download any simple Selenium scripts, add required jars, convert that into TestNG, later convert that into Maven, then run the TestNG XML, make sure that you are able to produce some reports. Once this is done, go to PowerShell and then install the scoop. Scoop, nothing but here Allure. It will download the Allure related component and install it. Other way is just download zip, place it in your local folder and give that path in the environment variables. This is what you have to do in the first section. Okay, I hope that this is clear. Very simple. This is everybody knows that how to configure and all that, so I don't have to stretch again and again. I just explained the setup here. Now focus on the Jenkins side, right? So once you have installed the Jenkins, then go to you'll get a dashboard something like this. Okay, then you have to create a new item. Okay, select Allure demo and select freestyle project, click OK. Okay, this is how we can create a project in the Jenkins. Again, Jenkins, you have to just download the Jenkins .exe file and execute this MSI, then set up your account, and when you set up account, once you logged in, it will preload all the installation part, just say yes and install all the plugins, related plugins and all that. So project is created something like that. Then let's go back to the Jenkins main page. So this is the project that I have created. Once project created, click on manage Jenkins under the main Jenkins page under the dashboard. So here few things you have to set up. One is that go to configure system, then we need to add JDK, Maven and any other supported configuration for overall dashboard purpose. So let's do that. I have already did it. I'll just walk through how I did it. So this is something like, this is a overall configuration setup, right? So here, if you want, you can add Jenkins location and all that, right? So this is the one thing. And second is, if you want to enable email notification, that you can do it, and Allure report. I'll come this later. This is just I want to show you that how the configuration setup is done. If anything is missing, you have to go and add it manually, right? So once this is done, go back, manage Jenkins again, then global tools configuration. Right, so once we go here also we need to configure a few things. Let's understand one by one. First, the main thing is that under the global config tools configuration, we need to add the JDK path. Go to your program files, Java, and take the JDK from there and set your JDK path. If you are using Git, same, it goes same. And Maven, again same, right? So the easy way is, what you can do, you go to your system properties, then click on advanced system settings, then click on environment variables. This is the Maven path, copy this, and again if you have Java, copy this and go back here, give the same path and click on save. So I have already did it. This is the settings that you have to do. Two things, JDK and Maven setup. Let's go back to the dashboard. And once those setups are done, and also you need to have some plugins here also. Go to manage plugins. To run Allure report and the TestNG report simultaneously, you need to install two things here. One is Allure plugin, other one is TestNG plugin. Just type Allure here, enter, and it will fetch and it will load. I think I have already installed it, so it won't be there. You basically have to come here, available section, type Allure you get, I'll show what the plugin name is. I just enable, check and install it, and again type TestNG, enable and install it. Okay, go to, I have already installed, so I'll show it here under installed section. So let's type Allure, right? See, Allure Jenkins plugin. This will be available here since it's all installed, it moved to install. So just check it. This is the one plugin you need to add from the Jenkins manage plugin manager, and other one is TestNG, right? TestNG results plugin. So this is already installed, so it's coming under the installed section. Basically these two will be in the available tab. Type TestNG, type Allure, install it, and once this setup is done, go back to your projects. I'll repeat again what you have to do. Once you logged in, go to manage Jenkins, go to global configuration, set JDK, set Maven home path, then go to manage plugin, go to available, select Allure plugin and TestNG plugin, install it. So this is the setup that you have to do. Once this is done, we already created a project here, go to that project, right? If you see, this is a plain board here, nothing is available because no configuration done. Let's go to configure here. Right, so what basically you have to do is, under the build tab, add execute window batch command, enable this, and under general tab click on advanced and select this use custom workspace. So the same project what I have downloaded is here. Okay, I'll select this path. If you see, this is the project I have kept here, right? I'm giving the path of that under directory and display any name like demo Allure project. Okay, then once this setup is done, you have Eclipse and you have also run the TestNG, right? And just create one bat file and place it in the project. Okay, I'll show what that bat file contains in it. Okay, this is the bat file. If you see, this is the bat file here, edit. So this is a simple command that Java command that we have written here. One is that you need to give the path, that is cd, your project path, right? Your project path, this is the one project path. Then you need to type java cp, okay, to run this project. You need to give the bin path, select bin and give the bin path. After that, semicolon, go to lib, copy the lib path. So you have lib directory, copy the lib path. Then type arg testng testng testng.xml. Basically this is the testng xml. This command will use by Java to run the TestNG scripts. Okay, now this is in the bat file. Go to Jenkins, under build you just type what, testng.bat, that's it, because you have already given the path here. You are saying use this space, workspace, and this bat contains the executable command, right? This bat contains executable command. And let me show you that bat again. Click on edit. You have to give the path of your workspace, then java minus ep bin path, lib path, library path, that means, then arg testng 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 dot xml. This is the path you have to set in the bat file and place it in the Jenkins. Okay, once this is done, let me go back, general, click on advanced, you get use custom workspace, go to build, type testng.bat. What code you have to return inside the bat, you already seen it. Then come back here, post build actions. Okay, so these are all coming because you have added plugins, right? Without adding the plugins, you don't see Allure report and testng reports. Okay, select this Allure report, just change this to target slash Allure results, then again select one more, that is publish testng results. You don't have to do anything here, just keep as it is. If you want to enable email notification, you can do that, but for that you need to configure email. I have video for this, you can go back and check SVN Jenkins configuration with email notification I have created. You can go back and watch my video there. Just do this email notification so that it will fetch all the result and send it to the stakeholders and respective recipients. For us, for this demo, we don't need this. That's it. Apply and save. See, previously it was not added. Since we added here, Allure report has come. Once we build, testng report also will come. Now let's try to build. Click on build now. So build will start. You also set the build on periodic basis, like suppose if you want to run this every hour, you can do that. Every day, you can do that. Every week, you can do that. Every month, you can also do that. It all comes under the periodic. You can set the periodic and run the reports. So it will nearly take some amount of time. It has to download the jars and run. So let's summarize what we have did so far. Okay. So the first thing is that basically you need to download some simple Selenium scripts or project from Google or wherever you can find. Or you have existing project, that's well and good. You need to convert that into testng. After testng, convert that into maven. Okay, in the maven pom xml, you need to add certain dependencies. Those are like JUnit, Selenium, testng, poi I'm using because of I'm reading some data from Excel, Allure testing, then remaining like compiler, maven compiler, because we are, this is a maven project, showfire because we need some reports, and we are giving the testng.xml here to so that we can build the test script. Once this is done, you need to install Allure in PowerShell. There are two ways to do that. One, you can download the zip and place it in your local folder, give the environmental variables. Second thing, directly go to PowerShell, set this or this command, you can get it from the Google as well. Just type scoop command, you will get. Set execution policy. If you're not allowed to do anything, then you set this policy. After that, you need to run IEX new object, new web client, download string, get scoop, that's sh. So if it's a new installation, it will be done. Otherwise, it says scoop update. Suppose you're running old Allure, it will update to the latest one. That's all. You don't have to do anything. Just close this. Then go to Jenkins. Go to build is run. I'll walk through how it looks like. Meantime, let me run one more build so that we'll get some good dashboard. So go to Jenkins. Okay. And go to manage Jenkins. Go to global tool configuration. Set JDK, set Maven home path here. It got slowed down. Let's wait for a minute so that I'll take you through the necessary screens. Yep. So this is the JDK path that you have to give. Then one more is Maven path. Once this is done, go back to the manage Jenkins. Then go to manage plugins. Here you need to download two add-ons, that is Allure and TestNG. TestNG results plugin and Allure Jenkins plugin. So once this is done, go to project where you have created a new project, right? Let me go to my dashboard. This is my project created, freestyle project. Just select that. Here you need to give TestNG bat command, right? So go to configure, under general tab, click on advanced, give the workspace folder path, then go to build. I'll just repeat again. This is where you get the general tab, click on advanced, use custom workspace, give the project where your project is loaded in your local system. Then go to build TestNG bat. Once you are able to run the TestNG report XML, convert into bat. So it's a very simple. What you have to do is create file, TestNG, save it as testng.bat. Under the file, what you have to type is give the project folder path and type javacp, give the bin path, library path, and then arg testng xml, so that this testng xml suite, whatever the test scripts are configured under this testng xml, will be run by this bat file from the Jenkins, right? So that's what we did. Then post build action, select Allure report, type target Allure results. Then one more select you have to do is TestNG result. Basically these two will come under the post build action once you have added Allure plugin and TestNG plugin, right? Then apply, save. So let's see what's happening. Go back to Jenkins and select this Allure project. Okay, so blue means success, and if anything, this ball comes in red color means build got failed. So blue means it's got success. So this is the Allure dashboard will be created on the front end. This is the TestNG report will be created. Let's analyze this Allure report, how it's coming. So there are 7 test cases executed under this script, TestNG scripts. So this is how it will categorize. So we can also customize this while writing the test script. I have not covered that. I have just explained how to configure in Jenkins. So these are all the 7 scripts executed. And what are those arguments passed? What is that? how many retries done to build happen, right? So that information we can see here. This is some graph it got generated. What is the severity level? What is the time taken for this? And some other information as well. And this is the timeline. So it got executed within 5 minutes. Then go to behavior, just observe what's here. So basically all these behavior packages we can control, we can write some more customization to this so that we can get meaningful report. This is the one that this is what pretty much Allure report. So a very good dashboard, similar to the extent report, where we have seen similar graph and design like that. But the Allure will give some more flexibility in terms of customization as well. So it's a good report to share to the stakeholders and give the complete script details. Let's look at the TestNG result as well. So this is how it looks like. Click on build to. There are 10 test scripts executed. This is some duration. So this is how TestNG reports will look like. So this is what, what is the status and all that. Anything else that you can do is, like, once this got generated, you can also add one more post build action where you can actually take these reports and send to your managers, your stakeholders, your clients, or whoever it is under the email notification configuration. Basically, you need to add them. Then once build is successful, this report will also go to them, right? I hope this is all of you are able to understand. It's very easy to configure everything. If you have everything running, it's very easy to configure. Let me quickly brief you on this. First, download Selenium project, configure to TestNG, convert to Maven, run the TestNG XML, make sure that you are able to run, get the reports, convert to the bat, then go to PowerShell, run these scripts, make sure that the Allure is installed and set the property, then go to Jenkins, create project called Freestyle. I'll go to Jenkins manage, go to global tools configuration, set up JDK Maven, and come back to the plugin manager, download Allure plugin and TestNG plugin. Once all the setup done, go inside the project under the general tab, click advanced, give the local workspace path, go to build, give the testng.bat. Go to post build action, select Allure report, select one more post build action, that is TestNG report, save it, come back to the dashboard, click on build and run the build. You will get dashboard on your screen. Thanks for watching this video. Any queries, you can comment me. Take care. Bye.